From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. State officials in Augusta brief lawmakers on what they say caused a $120 million shortfall in the state's Medicaid program. To fix the shortfall, Governor LePage wants to see significant cuts to the program known as MainCare. The Appropriations Committee heard from the Health and Human Services team that has been analyzing the problem. Democrats say the governor is not considering the long-term effects of the cuts, which would remove about 70,000 Mainers from MainCare.
It is through further scrutiny, not just looking backwards at what our spending pattern had been, but to look at what our projections are likely to be for the remainder of the year.
It's an attack on the most vulnerable. It attacks our veterans. It takes services away from the elderly, from the disabled, from children.
Now, the public will have a chance to voice their concerns over the potential cuts to several programs like prescription drugs at a public meeting tomorrow at 9. A federal judge has thrown out a lawsuit filed against the city of South Portland and several police officers for a deadly police-involved shooting 3 years ago. Terrence Norton sued the city, police chief Edward Guggins, and several police officers, claiming they violated the constitutional rights of his 29-year-old son, Michael Norton, when officers shot him during a confrontation in August 2008. According to the court ruling, Norton was suicidal and armed with a knife when he was shot by police outside of his home after a four-hour standoff. Tonight, a state trooper is credited with spotting an 82-year-old missing hiker. Happened in Durham, New Hampshire, shortly after 10 o'clock this morning. Trooper Timothy Stearns was in a helicopter when he was able to spot 82-year-old Bruce Charity's blue jeans in a wooded area.
He was able to, spot the helicopter and wave to him. In fact, he spotted the helicopter before they spotted him. So, fortunately, he started waving and they got right over him and got us a location so we could get in there.
Charity went hiking around 2 p.m. yesterday. He was reported missing around 6:20 last night when he failed to return home. When search crews came up empty last night, Charity was forced to spend the night in below freezing temperatures. He ended up suffering from hypothermia. Well, a group designed to help Maine students develop the skills they need to succeed in high school and beyond, it's getting a big boost. The AT&T Foundation presented jobs for Maine graduates with a check for $75,000 to help the organization expand. JMG has grown from serving 2,500 middle and high school students each year to now serving more than 4,000. The group says this money will help, especially during a time when school districts have shrinking budgets and disappearing resources.
AT&T made the investment because the program, the JMG programs, help students discover their own leadership skills and help them think about their future. And it gives them those skills that they need to create a plan and stick to the plan. And as a result, we have middle school students who are going on to high school. They're doing very well in high school. They're graduating, and our students are going on to higher education.